Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to RanDOTA. As always, I am D, your host for the show where the meta doesn't matter. Just dropped into this live cast. I'm going to switch to free camera. We're going to already have a pause because... Because we had two DCs. Good to know. I think they have to put a timer on there to show you how long you have until you get an abandon. But it's good to see there was a quick pause. I mean, it wouldn't be Dota 2 without a pause at the start of a game. This is about a high 6,000s MMR, I think around 6,700 or so. Guys, the Pudge is still disconnected. Now, one of the neat things here is... Who was it? I think it's on the... Yeah, they must have been on the Dire. There it is. If this is who I think it is, this might actually be Weeha. Legend, good old pro player. Haven't seen Weeha in too much recently, but... We'll go ahead and introduce the teams in just a moment. We got some fun, interesting picks this time around. In fact, there's one right there. This is actually something I mentioned a while ago. This is a great way to get a Shadow Fiend a great start, is if you have a Clockwork, give him Power Cogs. Somebody else hits the cog twice, or hits it once, and Shadow Fiend hits it a second time to get a deny, feeds him a soul. So you see he's already starting off with 10 souls, which is 20 damage higher than the enemy might be expecting, except for the fact that if they're smart, they'll know, hey, Clockwork can do this. We'll go ahead and introduce the teams. We have Parentheses in the top lane currently, playing on the Axe. Good solo offlaner, especially when you start with the Stout Shield and Counter Helix. Mid lane, currently we've got Peton, Pet0n, however you want to say that, playing on the Clockwork. My sound is peaking a little bit, sorry. I'll try and talk a little slow. I am so fucking bad playing on the Shadow Fiend with 12 souls already. They're both in the mid lane, so we got a currently dual mid. Detective, or Detect 1VE, playing on the Dazzle in the bottom lane, supporting all muted. Sorry, try to win solo. Playing Troll Warlord, which call you solo. For the Dire Squad, bottom lane we've got Mr. Doctor, playing on the Necrophos, fun name for somebody that's, you know, an evil doctor from in his backstory. N, or EN, playing on the Monkey King, currently jumping around the mid lane, looking like he might be trying to courier snipe here. Wee, playing on the Wind Ranger in the mid lane, so that, like I said, this might actually be the legendary pro Weeha, who's actually a very good pro, starts with Wind Run and already pops it once to avoid some damage, takes a ton though. Top lane for the Dire, we have Scream, playing on the Pudge, and Tool, playing the Slark. But we got a big bit of a fight going on in the mid lane. Wee's already taken a ton of damage, so has Bad on the Shadow Fiend. Ian turns around and smacks Peton. I'll call you Peton, because that's easier to say. This has been a bit of a blood-soaked mid lane so far, and we haven't even had a death. We have a dancing Shadow Fiend. They're just taunting each other. Shadowfiend's got some jazz to him with that taunt. I was gonna say, in terms of just raw damage output, the Shadowfiend's got this. But, ooh, Power Cog's not in the exact right spot. They could have actually pushed Wee into the cliff, which would have probably gotten the kill to Wind Run. And Bad would have been able to get the kill there. But nothing doing. Gain down a little bit, try and cut down on the peaking in my sound levels. Solo is actually doing okay. He's actually currently leading last hits. Poison touch out from Detective onto Mr. Doctor, but he's got Ghost Shroud ready. Peton coming in with a DD rune. This is going to be our first blood, looks like. There's the Power Cox, traps Mr. Doctor in there. Oh, there we go. Peton does get first blood after a bit of a weird mistake. If Doctor had not stood and tried to hit the cog, he might have been able to get out of there. But mistakes are kind of where the where one team falls and one team rises. Trialing in top, parentheses here, might be in trouble, because Scream and Tool, Pudge and Slark alone are going to be a dangerous combo. Mix in the Monkey King, who has done literally nothing this whole game except soak experience. Actually, wait, no, I take that back. He did contribute some a little bit in the mid lane. He's put a point into Jingu Mastery now. We'll see how he goes. He's actually off the trees for once. But he spent most of his time on the trees. I mean, yes, he is a monkey, so... Ooh, good power cut trap on Wii. He's gotta destroy it and get out of there, but... Primal Spring coming in, not gonna be enough. Ooh, actually it is. Piton taking a ton of damage. He's not gonna get out of this. Ian gets the kill, and he's suddenly got Jingu Mastery active. Bad has gotta run. Oh, Tree Dan. Tree Dan's up onto the top. He's chasing him. Primal Spring down. But he actually gets to the shrine, which is going to be enough to save him. Piton comes back in. Can he close the distance fast enough to get off the power cogs? Yes, he can, because he has boots, while N does not. Out comes the power cogs. N is in trouble now. He's trapped in with Piton, who manages to get a revenge kill. The Jingu Mastery almost saving N there, but not quite enough. We, on the other hand, did not fall that entire time. What bow is that? That is Genuine Rainmaker. Autographed by Yaya. If you're wondering how they can do an autograph on a digital item, Valve found a way. Oh, currently a Flying Rabbit Courier. Bad is actually at max souls, so he needs to put another point. Probably gonna put level 6 into Necromastery. That is not a courier. That is a Monkey King. That is what Trickery can actually do. Can actually turn you into a courier, can turn you into a tree, turn you into a banana peel. Primal Spring coming in. Bad actually catches the end of it, but not good. Two hits, three hits for Jingu, four hits for Jingu Mastery, and he gets the stun. He's now got four of the bonus damage and lifesteal. Let's see, he's currently got 15% lifesteal because it's only level 1 Jingu Mastery. Turn down the gain just a little bit more on my microphone so that we're not still peaking so much. Let me know. In the comments, if the sound gets a little weird, just let me know. I know about the wind noise that keeps happening now and then, but luckily with Audacity, it seems to be fixed. And going in on Bad, he's actually going to get this kill. And there's an actual tree there. That is a... You can use an iron branch to do that. Meanwhile, bottom tier 1 is under attack from Solo. Or his creep wave more than anything. He's actually got he's gone 2 points in Whirling Axes. 1 point in Berserker's Rage. And a single point in Fervor. And there's the point in Battle Trance. So if he wants, he can actually... hit his combo, and suddenly he's got a ton of... He'll just have a ton of attack speed. Invisipudge. Not super dangerous in terms of everything he can do, but that's because he's just not level 6 yet. Oh! Piton knows he's there now. Is he gonna cotton on to the fact that no, he's not. Or he might. Thirty souls is now the maximum. Oh. Meanwhile, Tool falls on the top lane to the axe. Parentheses. Oh, but instant revenge kill by N. I'm got Terry Goodkind. Famous author. Oop. Meanwhile, Wii falls in the mid lane, but Piton falls as well, this time to Scream, so it ends up being a 2-for-1. Scattered across the map, but hey, still 2-for-1. Only level 4 up on Doctor, whereas The troll solo is currently level 7, and almost about 7.5, really. Solo's keeping up. He's actually been our top farmer so far, 54 last hits and 12 denies. Let's check the net worth real quick. The top three are all on the Radiant side. And is currently just jumping around the tree line. He used that just to get up there and get a bounty rune. He's almost level 6. We'll see if he takes a point in Wukong's command when he gets there. 34 out of 46, or 34 out of 36 out of 36 souls now. You can actually get 46 souls with a scepter. A little bit of taunting. Oh, wow. Okay, so he's blaming it on his team. I mean, some of that will be the team, but this is a game, everybody. Remember that. This is a video game. You play it for fun. Some people do play it to try and make money, but that's actually one thing I'm looking forward to, because if you don't know, these next couple of months is going to be the lead up to the International 7. Or 2017. I think it's 7. I think it started in 2010. Hopefully this year will be a great year. I mean, last year we had a lot of fun with it. Although, to be fair, a lot of people still think 2014 was like the grand final was like one of the low points. I still remember 2013, TI3, first TI I ever watched, and just that grand final between Na'Vi and Alliance. I mean, there's a reason they call it El Clasico, because that one match. Oh, hold that thought. End Scream and Mr. Doctor going on Piton. Oh, the hook gets onto the Dazzle, and that's a great Wukong's command right there. Piton's in trouble. That's a double kill for N. Meanwhile, Tool has to pop Shadow Dance to get away from parentheses. So do it yourself, man. That's the thing. If nobody on your team is upgrading the courier, upgrade it yourself. Even if you're the mid laner, you have the most. You should have the most farm on your team. I mean, the safe lane Slark has more right now. I'm just like, people really do play better if you're positive. Cause it also applies to like real life situations. Cause if somebody's negative, like if your boss is negative and you a lot, if they're negative a lot, like, or they're just negative about your work, you're just like, well, you're just robbing me of the motivation to do any better. So yeah, be positive, people. Positivity doesn't hurt anybody. Negativity hurts everybody. Out comes the Battle Trance. Which, with a Shadow Fiend that took 20 attack speed, is going to be insane. Because it's 80 attack speed up for the Shadow Fiend. Whoa. Piton is in some serious trouble here. If he's not careful, that could... I mean, the camp wasn't going to kill him, but he's not careful, and he gets found by anybody. Although now he's got a Dazzle with him, so... I mean, there's only one point in Shallow Grave. Wii falls in the mid lane and got dunked. It's 5-6. The Dire's still leading, but... Yeah, I'm guessing that really is Weeha. But yeah, you always have at least one stack of fervor. Now we have had one tower fall, and it was in favor of the Radiant, so... The Dire are going to push top. Or the Radiant are going to push top, I'm sorry. Meanwhile, a level 8 Monkey King can be useful here, but... Primal Spring? Oh, and no, that's Wukong's Command, and whoa, they just blow up the axe. That was quick. Meanwhile, Wii's got to run back. He's died twice, so... That's a bad sign for the Radiant. Or for the Dire. I keep doing that, I'm sorry. Level 2 Requiem. Each line will do 120 damage, and currently he's got 18. Meanwhile, Scream managed to deny himself on the bottom lane. You gotta remember, when you're killing Pudge, you gotta stun him. Or silence him before Rot gets off. Otherwise, he will just try and deny himself by self-heal, or self-harm. I'm having a weird day today. I don't know why I keep messing up everything. Or messing up my words. It's been a while since I cast. Oop. The Ray's missed. Triple raise combos. That's actually a very difficult thing to land. Unless your enemy is just running in a straight line. And they know he's there. Out comes the Boundless Strike into the Ooh, good Reaper size combo. But the Shadow Fiend is here. He's got his Shadow Blade. He wants to get the Requiem off. Well, now they know he's here, so. Going for a Dragon Lance. Good choice on the Shadow Fiend, because he does need a little bit more range. 500's not great. I mean, it's average, but... Actually, let's see. Wind Ranger does actually outrange him by a little bit. Troll has a 500 attack range when he's using his ranged form. Dazzle has 550. Necro has 550. So Shadow Fiend is actually slightly outranged by most things. Meanwhile, the Shadow Fiend and the Troll Warlord are going on the Roshan. Solo keeps getting stunned up, but he's just tanking this because with Fervor and Battle Trance. Meanwhile, the Radiant are just wandering around. Power Shot comes out. Berserker's Call into the hookshot. Weeha's not making it out of this. Boundless Strike stuns up 3. But the dunks are there. The Radiant are going to transition this into a tier 1 push mid, maybe? Looking like it. Ghost Shroud comes out from the Necro, but it's like Shadow Fiend's like, okay, I'll just nuke you down with Shadow Rays. That is the one weakness of the Ghost... Oh, good hook from our Pudge, but that's not going to be enough. He pulls him straight into a Shadow Rays. That ends up being a double kill for the Radiant side. Ends. Killing streak goes down. Scream falls as well. Piton falls, though. Tool is in the Shadow Dance. Yeah, Ghost Shroud is not going to protect you from the dunks. Ends up being a 3-for-1. That was a support clockwork. For 2 cores. All 3 tier 1s have fallen for the Dire. This is not going well for them. I mean, and they're tied on kills. Oh, Tool finds himself right next to the Shadow Fiend. No Requiem to blast him into oblivion yet, but that's just a minute off. I was going to say something about last week's episode, but I cannot remember what it was. Ooh, Piton gets found out. Tool. Oh. Piton hooks himself out of his own cogs towards his Shadow Fiend buddy. Meanwhile, Scream just stands there and tanks the hits. The Shadow Fiend does have the Aegis, so this is not a great idea. Out comes the Reaper's Scythe. Doctor takes down Piton. Meanwhile, Parentheses stands strong, taking on like three enemies with a blade mail. Out comes Wukong's Command. And a double kill for Mr. Doctor. Tools on a killing spree as well. It ends up being 3-0. Or 3.5-0. Bad and Detective are just like, no, we're done here. So there's a regen right there, dude. Go get it. Presence of the Dark Lord always tells you if Shadow Fiend is around. Dire scan right on top of Weeha. There's nobody there, except Weeha himself. I do like how when Pudge activates his Rot with that item, it spins the claw. What is that? That's the Ripper's Reel. Screams. Bad just comes in and blows up the Pudge. That was kind of brutal. Looks like N isn't in the tree. He's up in the trees again, using his tree dance. I didn't put any more points into it, so he's only got the 1 point in Primal Spring. The Radiant gonna lose a tower anytime soon. Let's check theirs. Tier 1 on top is pretty low. Tier 1 in mid, also pretty low. Tier 1 on bottom, actually pretty healthy. N takes down Detective just out of nowhere. Yeah, they both did. Or he did, I was gonna say Tool did most of the damage, but it's the final blow that matters at the end. The hook misses. Just messing with him, I think. Looks like the Dire want to transition this into a push on the toughest of the towers. Oddly enough, this is actually fully in line with the Art of War, where you're actually supposed to attack at the strongest enemy point. Crush them at the strongest point, prove that they cannot stand against you. Out comes the Dismember, takes down the Axe. Parentheses falls to Scream. Echo Saber up on the Slark. Doctor's gonna go ahead and TP up to the top lane, help defend. Does have a single point in the Heartstopper aura. Tool pops out of Shadows onto Piton. Oh, but the Shallow Grave is gonna save him from the Reaper's Scythe. Not gonna save him from just being beaten to death and the Heartstopper. Solo takes down Scream. Where was this? Meanwhile, so far 2-1 across the map, but popping focus fire to kill some golems. Or a golem. Channeling, Bad is trying to channel at the Requiem. They know he's there now. That makes a ton of noise, so Tool coming in. Can he get this? No, he can't. Cannot be leashed. Weeha's just farming up in his own jungle. Or the high jungle, really. Let's do a quick talent check. We haven't done one of those yet. On parentheses, on the axe, we have a +3 mana regen. That's the only thing he's got so far. He's only level 13. Bad on the Shadow Fiend, 175 health and 20 attack speed. Tier 1 on top has fallen for the Radiant. Are we going to see some action here? Maybe. Meanwhile, solo on the troll, 10 agility, 15 movement speed. Oh, good boundless strike from N on the back line. Dust out. Ooh, the Shell of Grave is going to save bad. He's going to pop the Requiem. And that's a ton of damage, but a secondary Requiem as Tool takes him down. N takes down solo as well. Scream is in the middle of all this. Python actually gets the kill there. Dunk down onto Doctor. Two. It ends up being a 3-for-1. That Shallow Grave really helped out, because if the Shadow Fiend had not been able to get off the Requiem, that would have been a very different fight. Tool, meanwhile, makes it a 2-for-3 as he takes down Python. Right in the river. Speaking of Piton, +4 armor for his talent. He didn't make 15 yet. And Detective has +10 intelligence. Always a good idea on Dazzle. What's his other one? 125 health. 50th game. Yeah. It's not always a... Meanwhile, Tool. 15 strength, 15 damage. Yeah, there's actually not a lot of talking right now. Weeha. 40 move speed, 4 mana regen. Scream, 8 strength. Which means he's gonna get tons and tons of health at this rate. Doctor has 40 damage. And N currently has 5 armor. Some interesting talent choices. We'll see how this goes while we just watch this siege creep. Primal Spring comes out. N is not really doing well here, but Tool comes in to help him out. They pop, and they end up popping the Shadow Fiend there, and he's down for an 82-second sit. Thanks to the 20 added respawn time from the Reaper's Scythe kill. He only got off a single Shadow Raise. I mean, they did that fight very surgical, very strong. So well played to the Dire. We're going to switch over to directed camera for a moment, which means, of course, we're going to sit in here. What? Sit there and watch Weeha for a second. The tier 2 on bottom is under threat. Parentheses, he could do something here. He's got the blade mail, he's got the blink, he's got the berserker's call. Unfortunately, I don't think he knows N is up in the tree line there. Piton just wandering around doing nothing. Guided camera, come on. Actually, you know what? We're gonna go to Hero Chase. 1,200 people watching this game. Oh, they're gonna get the dazzle here. Detective falls. Piton falls as well. Solo comes back in, trying to help out here, but he's standing 4-on-1. He actually takes down one on his own. Ends up being a 4-for-1, a 3-for-1 there in the mid lane. Maybe a 4-for-1 as Parentheses falls as well. Weeha actually got that kill. The tier 1 in the mid is gonna go down as well. This is the game. This is the mid to late game that Weeha's team needed. Because, oh, they caught the Shadow Fiend. Can they get the Shadow? Can they get the Fiend? The hook! The hook from out of nowhere! That was a great hook. Just right there. You know what? Let's actually do a quick replay. We're gonna rewind back 10 seconds. A little bit more. That hook right there from Scream. Just a brilliantly played hook. And we're back live. At least I think we are. Yeah, we are. That's the first replay I've ever actually done in terms of doing that, but... Roshan falls to Tool and Mr. Doctor. Tool takes up the Aegis. Wee's up to a Maelstrom. He's building toward... He's got most of a Scepter. He needs about 800 gold. Yeah, just a little over 800 to get the point booster. And he'll have his scepter, which makes this a lot stronger, because it basically makes it so you don't lose any damage on focus fire. And just observing in the tree line, Primal Spring onto the Radiant Creep Wave. Out comes the Rocket Barrage. There's a random friendly, dire friendly Radiant Creep. We can go back to free camera now. All the Radiant are currently grouped up in the mid lane. This is actually dangerous. They got a three-man smoke. They found the Shadow Vein, and the Reaper Scythe comes out, but it's not going to be enough because it's the Shallow Grave. Axes standing strong. Out comes the Requiem, but it's not gonna matter. Scream does fall there, and falls as well. But Tool takes down the Shadow Vein. Tool has to run for his life, but luckily he's got Shadow Dance, and he's actually doubling back. This is smart. Just comes out of stealth straight into Piton, gets a double kill. Turns with the Battle Hunger on him. Pops it off, takes it off. Oh, but it's not gonna be enough. Tool's out of his line, and the dunk. But he's got the Aegis. Shadow Fiend has abandoned the game entirely. We'll keep going because this is already a 30-minute game. Tool comes back from the Aegis and just instantly gets a kill on the Dazzle. He does have a Skull Basher, so that could have canceled the TP, but not quite enough. Not a good enough RNG on that. Unfortunately, yes, even in high-level games, we do see people abandon. It's unfortunate, but luckily I don't think we've ever seen somebody just flat-out rage quit in a pro-level game. Yeah, the Radiant are just all leaving. They're controlling the Shadow Fiend to try and get him in here, but that's a fake Shadow Fiend who just got destroyed. Fake Clockwork. Are they gonna go for the Megas, really? Well, they already got mad, so they're gonna leave. Scepter is up. You don't need a BKB at this point. Nobody's fighting you. Yeah, this is, like I said, basically over. Well, unfortunately, we did have a couple of abandons, so yeah, at least the Axe player stayed around, so. Oh, there we go. That is unfortunately a dire victory that was not quite as entertaining as it could have been, but there we go. I hope you enjoyed, folks. I'm sorry about the abandons and all that, but it just happens sometimes. If you enjoyed the show, please be sure to like or favorite the video. You can also leave a comment down below if you have anything you'd like to say. And if you want to keep up with me, never miss any of my current series, please feel free to click the subscribe button down below or the icon at the end of the video. If you have a replay you'd like me to check out, send me the match ID. You find it right here in the bottom of the score screen. As for that, folks, I have been D. I'm not really sure either side won today, but the Dire did walk away victorious. So good night, and good gaming.